is my brutality! I eat, sleep, bleed, the demons in your dreams. I eat, sleep, bleed.
Jimmy Robinson on the sweep, and he's at the 5-3 touchdown.
Down the seam, wide open, touchdown, Rattlers!
Yo, it's the IFL, swear to man, become heroes in the end. Are you ready for that?
The 2024 IFL football season has been spectacular, including an unforgettable postseason already, all culminating in today's matchup in the IFL championship game between the 13-5 Arizona Rattlers and the 10-8 Massachusetts Pirates. It's a rematch of the championship game from 2021. That one a victory for the Pirates. The Arizona Rattlers would love to get some revenge today here in Henderson, Nevada. Hi, everybody. I'm Floyd Simmons, along with my broadcast partner, the Hall of Fame coach, Curtis Riggs, as we get set to bring you the IFL's championship game today here in Vegas. And Curtis, this is a game that is going to feature two teams that are at the top of their respective conferences, of course, as conference championships, both with slow points of the season. The Rattlers had a slow start. Massachusetts had kind of a slow interim period in the middle of the season, but they have all put that behind them, and they're playing great football today as they match up in the championship round of play.
Well, first, Floyd, it's a privilege to work with the best. I look forward to this, and yeah, we got a great game coming up here. Two teams playing their best football at the right point in the season.
Well, the Massachusetts Pirates, they ended up winning, and they had to come kind of the hard way through the Eastern Conference. They weren't the number one seed, but they got to the top. And here they are taking on the Arizona Rattlers. And you take a look at some of the special teams this team can do.
Yeah, they are the all-bus team. When they get off that bus, there's a major wow factor there. They have an impressive roster with a dynamic lineup that can make plays.
Well, they can run the football. They can throw the football. They do everything they need to do. Their defense is great. On the other side, how about the Western Conference champions, the Arizona Rattlers? A very slow start to their campaign, but they finished as strong as anybody, and they're looking good right now.
Well, and it's a sneaky getting into the playoffs type scenario because of that slow start. They had to go on a 10-game run in the gauntlet of the Western Conference that had so many good teams that were so evenly matched that everyone beat each other up, but they got better as the season went on, and that's what good playoff teams do.
You know, as good as these two teams are, I think there's very few people that would argue that the best teams standing are here today, in spite of the fact that they weren't top seeds in their respective conferences. In fact, that unforgettable postseason I talked about includes the fact that there were a lot of upset wins, a lot of road teams with victories in the playoff run to get here. Now, we're on neutral field. We're on a neutral turf here in Vegas, in Henderson, Nevada. This is Lee's Family Forum here, the site for a third year of the championship game. The Arizona Rattlers, boy, I tell you, they have played great defense. Their takeaway ratio, which is something that they count on, has been fantastic for them. On the other side, Massachusetts has one of the best defensive backfields in the game, maybe the best. We'll talk about that in a moment. But how about these quarterbacks? Why don't we talk about what these two teams will bring to bear here on the offensive side? And you always talk about the quarterback and what they can do for you. Let's talk about the guys on these two sides of the football, beginning with Arizona's Dalton Snead. I know, Coach, that you have some experience with this young quarterback, and he's got some experience, including a championship last year with Bay Area. Now he's the Arizona Rattlers quarterback. Your thoughts on how good this young quarterback has become for the Rattlers.
Yeah, we had the opportunity to coach Dalton Snead in Sioux Falls. Loved coaching him. I would say one word, moxie. I mean, he just brings a swagger onto the field that's contagious for all the other guys to follow, and that's what you know you're going to get. You're going to get a guy that lays it all out, and he's going to give you everything he has every single play.
Dalton Snead is the guy, of course, that will lead this Rattlers offense, and he did lead Bay Area to a championship last year. On the other side of the football, we're going to talk about a great quarterback who leads the way for Massachusetts. So grab a timeout, grab a break. We'll be back to get things going here in Henderson, Nevada. Lee's Family Forum is the site of the IFL's championship game, and we'll continue right after this. Back into Vegas, everybody, and today's broadcast of the IFL championship game. Welcome back in. I'm Floyd Simmons, along with my broadcast partner, the Hall of Fame coach, Curtis Riggs, very familiar with the game and these teams as well. We talked a moment ago about Dalton Snead, a guy you know, Coach Riggs. Let's talk about the quarterback leading the way on the other side. That's southpaw number 15, Alejandro Benefield. Experienced. He's got a championship under his belt already from 2021. Here's a guy that's just, you'd love to have a quarterback running your offense like him any day of the week.
Well, in his career, since he won that championship at Arizona, is kind of been like these two teams. It's been battling through injuries and then at the end of the season playing his best football. He's going to lead the team. Seasoned guy, can really sling the ball, but they have to protect.
The third member of our broadcast team is down on the field. His name is Joe Pequeno. We'll find out what Joe is doing as we get this championship game underway. Hey, Joe.
Gentlemen, welcome to the 2024 IFL National Championship game. I congratulate both teams on a great season to get here today. My name is Abram and I'll be your referee for this game. Along with me is your umpire, Mark Warner. Massachusetts, you are the visiting team. You get to call the flip. This is the coin we're going to use today. The IFL logo is heads. The team's is tails. Heads. Tails. What do you choose? He chooses heads. Would you please do us the honor of flipping the coin? It is a tails. Arizona, you've won the toss. They've elected to defer. You want the ball? Yes, you want the ball. Which way you want to kick?
Kick this way.
Excellent. Massachusetts will receive the ball to begin the game. Gentlemen, let's have a great one. Hold on.
Well, we're having some technical difficulties. I don't know if you caught that piece with Joe Pequeno, everybody, but we did get the coin toss. Arizona wins. They defer, and we're going to get to see Alejandro Benefield and the Massachusetts Pirates offense coming up first here in just a moment as we get underway with this season's IFL championship game in Henderson. This place is already rocking. You expect the energy, you expect electricity from fans assembled, and you're getting it today as we get set to get going. Alejandro Benefield, a quarterback for Massachusetts. You like a guy with that experience, don't you?
Love it. You just love the way he can carry that swagger out on the field. He's been here, he's done this, played great in that championship. He won against Arizona, at Arizona, and these last five or six games, you've seen that swagger kind of come back. Very explosive skill set of guys that he'll be thrown to.
Meanwhile, we're just a moment away from the kickoff today in Henderson. This has been the site of the championship for the IFL the past two seasons, now the third year at Lee's Family Forum. These two teams played the last championship in the IFL that wasn't a neutral site game. Coach Riggs, this was 3 years ago they played in Phoenix.
Yep.
In downtown Phoenix, it was the Rattlers hosting that championship and a close, hard-fought, but good win for Massachusetts to walk out of there with that victory. You can bet
the Rattlers, Rattler Nation, their fans, they want to get some revenge on this outstanding Pirates franchise.
Without a doubt. Yeah, I was at the game. It was actually the first time the Storm had not played in the championship in 10 years. And I went as a spectator because I knew you had two dynamic, well-oiled machines going to battle it out. And it was a tremendous game, very physical. And I think it's only going to get even more physical in this game today.
And we're set to get underway with today's IFL Championship game in 2024. A line drive kick off the foot of Dawson Evans for Arizona. That one bounces around, and an opportunity to get the Rouge. Tackle made in the end zone, and the Rattlers on special teams make the first big play of the game.
Yeah, you've got to be able to get out of the end zone, or it's 1 point for the kickoff team.
Receiving team failed to get the ball out of the end zone. That results in a one-point Rouge. Ball be placed at the five-yard line. First down, Massachusetts. Game clock. Please reset the game clock to 15. 1500, please.
It takes no time off the clock for the Arizona Rattlers to get the first point of the game. How important is it, Coach?
Thank you.
To get something big early, to make a play, to get an early lift, and the Rattlers certainly get one right there.
And just as important as that 1 point is the field position. To pin them back at the five, you're kicking to maybe the most explosive guy in the league in Robinson. Great squib kick, didn't give him a chance to really get going, and they pin him back.
Alejandro Benefield had to reach for that snap, gives it to Jimmy Robinson, and look at him do his stuff early on in this game as he carries it out from the five to near midfield. How about a 19-yard gain early on behind that big rough-and-tumble offensive line that he runs behind?
Well, this is where Mass has really made a commitment and really started to win games, is when they committed to the run game. Most dynamic player in the league, big offensive line. Let's let him get behind them and earn these yards, grind these yards out.
Rattlers make an early statement with the kickoff that bounces around, and they get the Rouge with their great coverage, which has been kind of a signature for them down the stretch here on special teams. But then it's the Pirates coming right back, making that big play, stealing some of that early Arizona momentum. And now Robinson will try the left side and get 1 yard. 1 yard as he gets knocked down right at about the 25-yard line.
Floyd, and if you see, when Mass goes that trip set to the wide side, Arizona will overload their defense to that wide side of the field. They'll commit heavy to that, and Mass is going to try to run to that short side away from that trips and try to outnumber Arizona as they continue to run at them.
So early on, we've watched the Pirates test the Arizona run defense. And on second down and nine, we'll see if Alejandro Benefield gets a throw for a first time. He does, and a quick release is caught on the far side of the field. Nice job of reversing field and getting enough yardage for the first down. That'll go to the 16-yard line of the Arizona Rattlers. As you take a look at the numbers this season so far for Alejandro Benefield, completing at nearly 70%, 1,680 yards, the 31 touchdowns to 6 interceptions is a ratio that you've got to really love if you're the coach of Alejandro Benefield.
Yeah, that 68% is tremendous, but you saw right there they went empty to get Arizona in a certain defense, then they brought their back in, faked, and had him continue to block, but Benefield still threw it with a guy in his face. If he can do that, Arizona's going to have some struggles.
Toss it, Robinson, left side, and he is able to take it out to near the 10-yard line. I think they'll mark him right there, maybe the 11. And he picks up another gain to bring him second down and relatively short for the Pirates offense as they march into Rattlers territory.
Yeah, and it's a big question if Taylor, the linebacker for Arizona, can make that open field tackle against Robinson. Not many people in the league can do it, and Mass is going to try to constantly create that one-on-one matchup.
So Robinson has already carried the ball multiple times in the opening series, the opening sequence here for the Pirates, and we'll talk about the wear and tear on his body that he might have to endure throughout this one. Not going to get it this time. They'll throw it toward the right side. That catch is made, and that'll be good for about 4 yards on the play. Massachusetts picking that up right there.
Yeah, and a guy that you're familiar with, Floyd, and a guy that it makes it really difficult to throw screens against is Merriweather. I mean, he's essentially a linebacker out in space as a strong safety and can really blow up those blocks and then make the tackle.
T.O. Redding on the receiving end of that pass. Stopped just shy of the first down. So first down and a third down and one. Pardon me, the down marker on the field hasn't been reset. It is third down and a yard. Robinson, right side, and he is not going to get the yardage necessary. That was a great job. The guy that came in to make the play is the guy you highlighted, the linebacker, Connor Taylor. He's going to have to make a lot of those kind of plays today, and he's able to stop him short on third down.
Well, and Mass tries to run against a box that's got, you're outnumbered. There's five defenders going against three offensive linemen. You can't block them all, and Arizona's very aggressive, attacking downhill. They're making you have to throw against the man-to-man coverage.
So fourth down and a little better than a yard to go. The Pirates with their first big test on offense. They toss it to Robinson. He's got the room for the first down, and he is going to push ahead. The ball came out somewhere in the sequence. The Rattlers are celebrating like it's their football. And they've got the larger contingency of fans. It feels a little like a home game for the Rattlers early on in this one. Still waiting for the official to give indication. And they do. Arizona Rattlers football, they force the first turnover of the game.
Well, and it's a great call. Robinson gets the first down easy, thinks he's going to score, and then just get a helmet right on the football, and then a scrum for that football. You can see guys just diving in there.
Couldn't tell if that was Amari Alexander, the defender, or if it was Dylan Winfrey. They were both right there on top of the play, and the hat just happened to be in the wrong place for Jimmy Robinson, didn't it?
Yeah, and I think Alexander just actually got blocked right into Robinson and put the helmet right on the football. Huge play right there.
So the Rattlers get the first takeaway of this game. They'll get the ball at their own 2-yard line, and out comes Dalton Snead, the defending most valuable player of the IFL championship game. That was from last year. He led the Bay Area Panthers to a championship, and now he'll try to do the same thing for the Arizona Rattlers. He gives it to Shannon Brooks, and Brooks goes around the right side. Shannon is going to get to about the 5-yard line. Dalton Snead, this young quarterback with championship experience, completing passes at about a 64% rate, nearly 2,000 yards passing. 40 touchdowns, 9 interceptions. I think 3 of those interceptions came in one, maybe 4 in one game. He's had a pretty good solid season outside of maybe that one performance.
The one thing I've seen this year, though, is there's going to be one or two passes every game where you just kind of hold your breath and think, what are you doing? Poor judgment, poor throw. But then the rest of the game, he's going to make it up.
Jamal Miles tries to go around the left side, and there is that big defensive line coming to play for the Pirates. And you'll see that play result in a, check it for you here, a very short gain on the play for Jamal Miles. The ball at the 6-yard line.
I think it was Montgomery that made the tackle. He just shed the offensive tackle. A very athletic edge player. It's really tough to try to get outside. You have to try to scheme them is what you do.
Sam Montgomery making that play, and you looked on the close-up there. He's got that old-school football helmet, right? The one that's got all the marks and the scars to it from a tough season of play. Dalton Snead directing traffic, escaping near the sideline. There he goes across midfield. And Arizona's quarterback is going to take it to about the 13-yard line of the Pirates. I don't know how he escaped on the dasher on the far side, but he did, and he turned that into a big, big play.
Yeah, he's actually able to slip under the defender right here. He just kind of ducks underneath. Ooh, that's close if he touched that wall or not.
Well, I don't see a challenge flag out anywhere, so we're going
to... Those are the plays right there, though, that make Dalton so exceptional. He's not flashy. He's not the fastest guy, but he's just so gritty. He's able to make those plays that kill a defense.
And he's got his team at the 13-yard line of Massachusetts under pressure. He throws over the middle. That's in and out of the hands. No, it's caught. It's caught by Shannon Brooks, who ran a little crossing route. And Dalton Sneed, with pressure in his face, able to complete the pass.
Yeah, and for such an aggressive style runner of Brooks, he really does a nice job catching the ball in space. Here it did look like he dropped it. He was able to still bring it in, but he runs with such aggression. You just think he's not going to be able to catch the ball very well. He does a very good job out in space there.
So the Rattlers continue to move the football. 4-yard gain on the previous play. The ball now at the 9-yard line of Massachusetts. Sneed throws wide open. Jamal Miles on the receiving end for the Arizona Rattlers. They're on the board with the game's first touchdown.
Yeah, and you'll see they fake to the back. And number two, the corner, he bites on that fake. You cannot get your eyes in the backfield. You have to stay committed to your zone. Coach Guy really taking advantage of the aggressive play of Mass, and an easy touchdown for Miles.
Dawson Evans on to try the point after this one. Will pierce those uprights. And the Arizona Rattlers jump out to an 8-0 lead thanks to that touchdown point after in the previous Rouge. It's 8-0 Arizona. Stand by. More of the Indoor Football League's championship game continues right after this. So it's the Arizona Rattlers that strike first. They get the Rouge to put a point on the opening kick of the game. And then the fumble by Jimmy Robinson, scooped up by the Rattlers defense. They went the length of the field with the ensuing possession. And a touchdown pass to the veteran Jamal Miles puts points on the board. Another tough to handle kick. This one is going to come out and just sneak out to the 3-yard line. That could have been another disastrous moment there early on. And this team that got two Rouges in their playoff victory over Frisco a couple of weeks back, they were victimized earlier and almost again right here. Jimmy Robinson back there unable to.
During the return, illegal block in the back, number 54, receiving team. That penalty being forced half the distance to the goal, it is first down.
And he's struggling with the depth and perception on this kick, and you can see the frustration with the Mass players and coaches. You know, starting to bicker and argue a little bit about it. This is where Benningfield just needs to bring them back together and say, hey, take a breath. Game is early. Let's get this back going. We had a great drive. We should have scored. We're okay.
Nose of the football on the Massachusetts 1-yard line after the penalty was assessed. And we'll see if Alejandro Benningfield is able to settle his guys in early on in this. Down 8-0. Look left, throw right. Robinson has it through his hands. Connor Taylor was breathing down his back there. And it's incomplete to bring up second down from the 1-yard line.
Boy, that is a bold call to throw a screen out of the end zone. You see him talking to the offense coordinator. Bones is his nickname. And that's a courageous call, even with a veteran quarterback, because you still have a defensive line coming free. And you don't know if your guy's going to be there or not.
So throw the book out early on this one.
Yeah, and this is when Coach Guy's got to be licking his chops right now, really coming after Benningfield because he doesn't have much room back there to work.
Going to put a lot of pressure on him. And a quick release to the near side. The pass is caught. And it will produce a short gain, very short gain. And the guy on the receiving end is a guy that is well known across this league. Isaac Zico has the ball, didn't get much out of it, but enough to give a little breathing room. 2-yard gain.
Yeah, played at Purdue, tremendous receiver, great hands, great route runner. But I mean, that's a difficult situation. Man-to-man coverage, the DB is going to be up tight, so you don't really give him a chance to make anything happen there. Now a big, huge third down, because if you have to kick out of here, you're essentially going to kick it out of bounds. Definitely feels like a home game for the Rattlers here, Floyd.
Big play on third down. Here comes the pressure. Got some good blocking from Jimmy Robinson. Gave the quarterback time to complete the pass for a big, big first down.
Yeah, and you're exactly right, Floyd. A huge block by Robinson. Steps up, cuts the linebacker. Clean pocket for Benefield. Hits his main receiver.
Ball out to the 19-yard line. Breathing room for Alejandro and his offense. Jimmy Robinson up the middle. And that tackle made by Devontae Merriweather. And he is going to be knocked down at about the 23-yard line.
Yeah, and Merriweather sheds the block here and then comes right into it to make the tackle. That's a lot of room, though, for Robinson. Arizona's got to be leery of giving him lanes like that because he'll really hurt you, that defensive front.
One of the few guys that plays kind of that hybrid linebacker slash defensive back position that can kind of stay with that cut with Robinson is that guy Merriweather right there.
Yeah, and when we beat them in the championship in 19, we tried to put him always opposite of the way we were going to go. We didn't want him anywhere near the play.
Catch made on a beautiful pass delivered by Benefield.
Mass doing a great job of hitting those dig and crossing routes, which are really good against man-to-man coverage here. You see they're going to run at you full speed, speed cut across, and a great throw by Benefield. Benefield looks sharp, which has got to be making Coach Miller feel really good about where they are, even with the struggles they've had so far.
Tino Redding, the guy that hauled it in. Jermaine Dobbs, the defender there for the Arizona Rattlers, and that takes it to the Arizona 16-yard line for a second time today. Massachusetts driving into Arizona territory to the end zone, way overthrown, that ball out of bounds. Yeah. Pressure was coming from Connor Taylor up the middle.
And the first time we saw him go empty, they went empty and no block for the linebacker. So he's got a blitz coming. He's got a throw. Great man coverage, though. He just throws it away.
Timeout. Massachusetts, their first of the half.
So the Pirates will extend a timeout. We'll grab a timeout here in the first quarter of this IFL Championship Showdown between the Arizona Rattlers and the Massachusetts Pirates. The Rattlers in front 8-0. We'll continue in just a moment from Henderson, Nevada. Stand by, football fans. Coming up, catch the CFL's interdivision action as the Edmonton Elks face off with the Hamilton Tiger Cats right here on CBS Sports Network. Meanwhile, the Massachusetts Pirates go to work with Jimmy Robinson trying the right side, and the Arizona Rattlers are going to bottle that one up. Coach, they went to short side of the field, and the Rattlers were not fooled.
Well, one of the reasons is because Arizona's not respecting Benefield as a run threat at all. I mean, they are collapsing all for Robinson, and then Benefield's just pretty much by himself. The other thing, that the timing and the motion by Mass is awful. They got to do a better job getting back deeper, attacking full speed at the line of scrimmage, and then Benefield's going to be able to have more space to work with.
Minute 45 remaining in the first quarter of the 2024 Indoor Football League Championship game in Henderson, Nevada. Alejandro Benefield puts him in motion, throws to that side of the field, and sails that one high. Incomplete, intended for Carrington.
Yeah, and this is one of those difficult things that Arizona will do is they'll have Merriweather work underneath with Winfrey over the top playing man coverage. So it'll slow the receiver down because he's got to go around Merriweather, and then you still have to deal with Winfrey in the backfield.
And so another great job by the Arizona Rattlers defense to slow down Massachusetts and put them in a situation where they're going to try a 34-yard field goal. And in the IFL, 34 yards is easy to attain, but can you kick it straight? That's always the question. And the answer this time is no. The kick sails wide to the right, and the Rattlers bringing their fans to life here in the championship game, and Henderson have gotten the ball back, and they've turned away Massachusetts with no points again.
Well, a big thing is kind of a bend but don't break mentality. And this kick here, it looked like he would have taken out a big divot if it would have been a grass field there. He really got under that. A good kicker. They really need him to come in and make some big ones. Look for him to drop kicks sometimes too on extra points, but Mass has got to kind of help get them back in this game with their defense now. Not necessarily a big play, but they need to slow things down.
That kicker, Henry Nell, from Pretoria, South Africa. Playing here in the Indoor Football League, but unable to connect on that. Nice cutback, and Shannon Brooks, few will give you the kind of effort that Shannon Brooks delivers on game day, and he's going to bring it out to the 18-yard line, taking his team out of the shadow of their own goal line.
Yeah, and a great job by the right tackle, and then Brooks makes a great cut. Really a solid running back in the league this year. He's had a great year, had a battle through some injuries, but you see him make the big play here, which has been a staple for making Dalton Snead better, because where he can rely on a run game will open things up for him.
And the Rattlers may be asking for timeout.
That is the end of the first quarter.
To get a timeout, because everybody gets one. We all get a timeout. That brings us to the end of the first 15 minutes of spirited play in this championship game. Arizona in front, 8-0, and with the football when we return for the second quarter. In a moment, everybody, stand by. More of the Indoor Football League's championship game continues right after this. Well, the Arizona Rattlers joined the IFL in 2017, and when they did, they ended a long championship-winning streak of the Sioux Falls Storm, if I'm not mistaken, yep. Coach Ritz.
Yep, at our place, too.
You know something about that?
Yeah, we beat them in the regular season. They came in playoffs, and they got after us. They did a nice job.
You watch a completed pass on the far side of the field. Corey Reed, Jr., hauling that pass in from Dalton Snead, and that's good for about a 6-yard pickup on the play, taken out to midfield. I bring that up, Coach, because this is a league built for parity. I love what the league does with their rules, the veteran rules, to try and encourage that these teams that compete in the IFL would, you know, be playing and competing on equal footing. And since the Rattlers won that 2017 championship, no team has won a second championship. All of the champions since that time frame, as you watched. Again, Corey Reed going ahead for a big pickup for the Rattlers. He'll take it inside the 15 or to about the 15-yard line. Point is this, one of these teams today, whether it's the Rattlers or the Pirates, is going to win this game, be champions. It will be the first repeat champion. Now, I don't mean back-to-back championships, but the first repeat champion of anybody since 2017.
Yeah, and I think you're exactly right. The parity, I mean, you see just how dynamic it's getting. Everyone is doing a better job recruiting younger players that want to move up, they want to get going, and coaches are getting better and better at schematically understanding the indoor game.
How about three straight gives to Corey Reed Jr.? He's caught two passes now. There was a catch right there that will take it to about the 12-yard line. And, of course, he ran the ball in the middle of all that. So Corey Reed getting his number called a lot right now for the Rattlers offense.
Well, and doing a great job of getting the ball out of Dalton's hands quick here. They're just trying to let him get in a rhythm, get a flow of the game, incorporating the run game in different ways, and eventually they're going to pop one over the top and let him try to throw down the field.
Rattlers in front, 8-0. Here as the second quarter gets underway, see if they can add to that with this possession. Dalton Snead from the empty backfield looking over the middle. That pass is nearly intercepted. Great job undercutting the route and getting hands on it. There's a marker down with some contact made. It was the intended receiver was Niger Jackson. And check the defender. I believe that was C.J. Holmes.
Yeah, and C.J. Holmes makes a great play on the ball, but it's before the ball gets there.
Prior to the pass, holding, number 21, defense. That penalty being forced half the distance to the goal results in an automatic first down.
Yeah, and I think this is a pretty soft call in this setting, but you do see him grab his hip to undercut. It's what DBs will do. Both sets of defensive backs on both teams, they're going to have hands on the guys, and they're going to pressure those officials to have to make these big calls.
You like this defensive backfield for the Pirates, don't you?
So athletic. You got Elam, who was drafted by the Ravens, played in the NFL, and all these guys, great size, great athleticism.
Handoff right side, Shannon Brooks turns it up, throws that forearm out there and gets his way into the end zone. He makes a huge statement with the finish, and Shannon Brooks has gotten the Arizona Rattlers on the board again.
Yeah, and a dose of what Mass was trying to do to Arizona. They run that short side zone, And this is how you finish to get in the end zone. You watch Brooks here. I mean, they seal that off. There's no one, and Brooks just finishes it. Look at that.
Shannon Brooks, I mean, that's the only way he knows how to play football. He plays, he gives you every ounce of effort on every play. And now Dawson Evans will add the point after for Arizona. The Rattlers lead at 14, make it 15. 15 to nothing early on as we bring you the IFL Championship game here from Lee's Family Forum in Henderson, Nevada. Well, Coach, Shannon Brooks, I mean, that's the only way he knows how to play football. He plays, he gives you every ounce of effort on every play. And now Dawson Evans will add the point after for Arizona. The Rattlers lead at 14, make it 15. 15 to nothing early on as we bring you the IFL Championship game here from Lee's Family Forum in Henderson, Nevada. Well, Coach, Rattlers have been playing hot football. You know, down the stretch, they're winners of 9 out of 10 games. They've won 5 in a row coming into the championship here. That Massachusetts team has equally been hot, and their last 6 quarters of football are unmatched. They played so well that come-from-behind victory to beat the Frisco Fighters that saw them get a couple of fourth-quarter rouges and overcome a 2-touchdown deficit in the fourth quarter to win that playoff game and then beat the top team in the Eastern Conference. And I mean top by a long way. Green Bay, what a great year they had. Massachusetts beat them in the Eastern Conference Championship game. And really, the game wasn't close at any point of it. I mean, yeah. The Pirates dominated, and that's how they got here to the championship.
Well, and talking to Coach Guy going into that game, you know, I'm like, hey, who would you rather play here? And he goes, well, Green Bay's had a great year, but they don't strike fear into you. I mean, you're just not fearful of them and then playing at this point in the season. Whereas he's like, Mass has got the guys. They got the guys that they put fear in you. Sometimes that fear is good. I mean, it really makes you prepare, practice is sharp. You know what you have coming in. You're not going to look past them. And that's how Arizona looks right now.
The Rattlers with 12-19 remaining in the first half. Get out to a 2-touchdown early lead. So that's not unfamiliar territory for the Pirates to work from. But I'm not sure they played a team and had to overcome a deficit like that as good as the Rattlers are. Here's a high kick fielded at the 7-yard line. And the spin will take it out to about the 17. That's where Isaac Zico brings it. And the Pirates will take over.
Well, and I think you're right. The amount of pressure that Arizona is going to keep putting on them. But all Mass needs is one good drive, one big play. I mean, you get this score 15-7 or 15-8, you finally take a breath and say, hey, we're back in this. But if Arizona keeps that 2-touchdown lead or even more, that's a daunting task then.
So to use a term familiar to folks here in the area, Vegas area, are you playing with house money when you get a lead like this early and you can you just can start to be more and more aggressive, right?
Yeah,
take
exactly
more chances.
Right. Yeah, and it puts more pressure on Mass because now you have no room for mistakes now.
Well, this pass caught by Carrington is going to be caught and taken out to about the 23-yard line near midfield for the Pirates, but there is a marker down.
Yeah, it's going to be an illegal defense. The linebacker was moving. He wasn't ready for the play here, so it was a free one, and Mass is going to want to take this.
Illegal defense, number 10, not aligned at the back of the box. 5-yard penalty remains, first down.
So the Rattlers, maybe just a skosh late in getting set defensively for the play. Flagged on that, and it's 1st and 5. Well, Coach Riggs, at one time, and for quite a while, you were the all-time winningest coach in indoor football, all iterations of indoor football. You finished your coaching career with the Sioux Falls Storm the year before this season, last year, 261 victories. To which, by the way, I would always congratulate you. Hall of Fame effort. Here's a pass deep that's incomplete over the head. And Benefield has had a hard time finding his guys downfield. He has overthrown a lot early on in this game. But, Coach, I come back to this thought here on you and the 261 wins. Well, now, Kevin Guy, longtime rival of yours here in this league. Coach Guy now with 263 career wins. He's established the new mark for indoor victories. And boy, I tell you, it's congratulations to him. And it's been a long road to get to that 263 wins.
It is. It's a long road. And you know what it comes down to? Having great owners, great people around you, great organizations. That's how you get to that point. I mean, it's nothing you do by yourself, that's for sure.
And a quarterback sack. A couple of pump fakes. There was a marker down in the defensive backfield, but Alejandro Benefield couldn't find a guy. He just couldn't. And the pressure coming at him finally got to him. He'll take another look at it here as we see if the sack stands, and it will.
Holding, number 5, defense. 10-yard penalty resulted in an automatic first down.
Well, I thought it would stand. They marked the ball where the tackle was made, and now they'll step it off from the line of scrimmage.
Well, and this is what we talked about with those handsy defensive backs. A lot of man coverage. When you do that, you're going to engage and grab on, and then what are the officials going to call? What are they going to give you leeway with? Coverage was outstanding. Benefield had nowhere to go. You see him starting to get antsy in the pocket, wanting to throw, and that showed with that long deep ball. He overthrew it by 6 yards. He got rid of it before he really got his feet set.
Coach Guy has wanted to bring pressure. He'll try to bring some more here, but the give is to Jimmy Robinson around the left side, and we'll get yet another penalty flag.
Yeah, this is going to be a hold on the offensive tackle. Anytime you see a defensive end where the running back runs out there with no one around and he's trying to get out, that's usually a hold.
Holding, number 74, offense. 10-yard penalty, remains first down.
Coach, to bring it back on that thought, the longevity it takes and the consistency it takes to, you know, win that many football games like Coach Guy has, like you did in your days coaching in this league. Here's the other thing. You mentioned, and you give a lot of credit to the ownership. I think that's 100% accurate, and it's called on. You've got to give them credit. You've got to have that good situation. But you're not going to be around for long if you're not getting the job done as a coach. If you can't scheme, if you can't bring in the players, if you can't win on game day, you're not going to be around for a long time, because those owners, they're going to find the guy who can, and they're going to send three receivers deep. Are the Pirates, and a pass intended for Carrington will be through his hands out of bounds. He's asking for some help from the official.
He's asking if there was some fan interference. Did the fan reach over? But it wasn't. I mean, the ball went over the wall first. You're right. I mean, you have to perform. You have to do your job. But it's got to be all the parts working together. And I think that's something that the ownership in Sioux Falls and I and my coaches and players were all able to do. And it led to the 11 championship. That's what we hang our hat on most. It's not all those wins. It's we brought our fans all those championships.
Well, and you know what? Massachusetts Pirates didn't win as many games as the Rattlers did this season. Three fewer, but they could win a championship today. But you're going to have to complete that pass. Now when Sale's out of bounds.
Well, and if you watch Benefield here, watching the replay, watch how he throws this. He's drifted back. And this isn't going to work. I mean, this is not something he can get by with. Watch him. He wants to throw it. Now he's got to get rid of it. And he's just fading backwards to really just a spot, hoping. That's a 500 ball there. Kevin Guy's got to be licking his chops seeing that.
Well, when you come into a game and you've got a game plan, and I know that Coach Guy wanted to put pressure on the quarterback, when it's coming together for you, I mean, how does that make you feel as a coach?
Well, one of the things they're doing well is they're blitzing, making Robinson always have to block, and you can see it wearing him down a bit.
This one is completed to Robinson, and he'll get hit into the boards inside the 10-yard line. Contact put him out at the 5-yard line, and it will be first down and goal. The Pirates again threatening, and certainly Pirate Nation hoping to get their first points on the board.
One great call. Way to get Benefield a little more composure. Mass probably got away with a little hold there on the nose guard. Big Perry got kind of pulled down, but get your playmaker the ball in space.
We saw Jimmy Robinson carry the ball a lot on their opening possession, and now they've tried to mix it up more, I think they're going to go back to number three, don't you?
Yeah, but you got to be creative how you run at this five-man look right here against Arizona in the red zone.
Toss it to him. Robinson will try to cut back, and he is unable to get it done. Nwaya is there for the Rattlers on defense. When those big guys can bottle up, can cage up a tough to bring down guy like Robinson, boy, that you know your defense is getting work done.
Yeah, and we wouldn't even try it. I mean, why try to go into their strength? We wanted to make their defensive backs, their corners, always have to tackle our bigger receivers, and we just thought we could wear them down by the end of the game. Trying to run into that wall all game long is just like beating your head against the wall.
Benefield stands, throws, and he throws into the crowd one more time. That is Dylan Winfrey in coverage defensively for the Rattlers, the guy that they were trying to get the ball to on that left side of the field. That I'll have to check for you again here.
You know, and that replay was great. It shows Robinson, the blitz is coming. He just sits back and waits. He's got to go attack. And you can tell right now that blitz is already starting to wear him down, having to block it. Down here in the red zone too, Floyd, guy they're missing, Owens. Owens is their red zone guy. That's a big loss for them down here.
Deactivated last night. It was Carrington on the last attempt. Isaac Zico will turn it up. And boy, I tell you, he got his shoulder square to the line of scrimmage. Looked like he was headed downhill to pay dirt. But once again, that Arizona Rattlers defense was there, and it was the defensive line that was Roderick Perry, you know, covering a lot of ground that helped to make that thing happen.
You can't flow the same way you're going to run. You got to take the defense the opposite way and go the weak side with it against one or two guys. When you flow, Arizona's defense runs so fast, they're going to be there. They're going to have too many guys there to make tackles. You can see the confusion, too, with the Mass offense right now. Seems like they're not quite sure what they need to be doing.
From the two-yard line, fourth and goal for Massachusetts. That was a little bit of a mix-up in the backfield. They'll stop that play right now for a false start, and the Rattlers are going to get perhaps a break. But Massachusetts with some confusion again in the backfield.
Yeah, and I think false right start. Now...
Number 11, offense. Three players in motion prior to the snap. Five-yard penalty, remains fourth down.
What? And you watch and you see the body language. The hands up, the questions, guys looking at each other, coach going out, and they need to get him back. He needs to be back on the wall here. But you see Benefield right there expressing his frustration too.
So the play comes in from the sideline. And Alejandro Benefield and company will try to get some much-needed points on the board here from the 7-yard line. Fourth and goal for the Pirates offense. Motion to the right side of Benefield. He's got time to throw. Plants, throws, and it's incomplete. Trying to throw it into the dasher board in the end zone on the right side to Darren Carrington. He couldn't hold on. Contact came immediately when the ball arrived from Jermaine Dobbs.
Yeah, and they try to run these push routes. So they'll go in hard into the middle of the field and push back out. Benefield throws a little bit late, though.
So an incomplete pass. Another defensive stop by the Arizona Rattlers will grab us a timeout, everybody. 15-0. The Arizona Rattlers with this first half lead over the Massachusetts Pirates. The IFL championship game continues right after this.
The Indoor Football League National Championship on CBS Sports Network is sponsored by Chapman Automotive Group. One of the largest selections of new and used cars for sale online in Arizona and Nevada. And by Mimosa Royale, a women and minority-owned company that brings you the world's first ready-to-drink mimosa.
Well, the Massachusetts Pirates have scored 104 points in the playoffs so far. They're two playoff games that got them here to the championship round of play against the Arizona Rattlers. But so far today, they have been denied every time by that Rattler defense, and Arizona gets another turnover on downs. And they lead it 15 to nothing here as we approach halftime. We've got 4:44 left in the second quarter, and a face mask is going to be called on a Shannon Brooks carry around the right side. He got it out there to about a 4-yard pickup, but somebody dragged him down by the headgear.
Well, and you want to start this drive the same way you started every other one.
Face mask, number 90, defense. 15-yard penalty to be added to the end of the run. First down.
You know, one of the things that I've seen about Kevin Guy is, you know, Kevin is not the kind of guy who cares about numbers, Coach Riggs. He doesn't care if his quarterback throws for 8 touchdowns or none. He just wants to get victories. And I wouldn't be shocked with the lead developing early if we see a lot of Shannon Brooks running the ball, keeping it on the ground, extending the clock and getting to the finish line as fast as
you know, I think that's the perception, Floyd. Run the clock, run the ball, but the clock runs no matter what. So I think what Kevin's going to do is, hey, we're going to call the safest plays rather than just run the ball to run the clock. We're going to run plays where we don't put our defense in bad situations.
Massachusetts is challenging the previous play, stating there was a false start by the right guard. Previous play, I'll leave you to further review.
So the false start would negate the play that resulted in a face mask.
Yeah, it would. And Mark Stout, a former head coach, is over there on that iPad all game long watching for these things. This is really a bold one here, though, because, yeah, you can't create with the replay, though. That's what they're going to say. And so is it clear-cut, decisive, that besides slow playing it, does it show it? Here, I mean, it looks like he's getting his hand up before it moves. But it'll be difficult if they call it.
Well, we've gotten a look here. You'll take a look, everybody. Certainly appears to be moving.
Yeah, that's a great eye by their staff to see that. And you know why it's a big call? If it was just the running play, they probably wouldn't challenge it. It's that 15-yard penalty.
It's going to be Izzy Fasciani that is flagged if it stands that way. The ball right now is at the 24-yard line, and the officials continue to look it over.
And you saw these guys all season. Fasciani coming back and moving the center, getting their all-league center back in there, I think was a big, big positive change for them, too.
Yeah, Cole Carter being that center. And here comes your call.
Upon further review, number 78 did commit a false start. That penalty being forced half the distance to the goal. The personal foul face mask now becomes a dead ball foul, which will also be enforced 15 yards forward from that spot. It is first down.
See, that's what I questioned. Is the act still happened? They still have to penalize it. So is the challenge even really good to do here? Because what they're going to do is just move it back 5, and then now they're going to add 15 on.
So you win the challenge, but, you know, what did you win?
Yeah, it's a frivolous challenge when you only get 2. Now you won that, you get a second one, you can get a third if you win that one, but you also lose a timeout too, and they have got to get a score before the half. Arizona gets the ball first coming back out. Kevin Guy's thinking, if I can get a score here and I get the ball first, because he is very much that arena-style mindset, controlling the clock, and it was something we as coaches for the Storm really looked at. How did they do clock management in the Arena League? Because I think there was so much to learn from that, with onside kicks and that last minute of the game.
So the net difference is, just like you said, Coach, it's about 5 yards, maybe 5.5 yards of net difference. And the Rattlers are going to have a first and 10 at their own 20, yeah, their own 18-yard line.
And they lost a challenge, Mass.
Handoff. Jamal Miles, the veteran, runs right into the back of his blocker. Shannon Brooks. And the tackle is made. Woodby was there. Harris Ford there, and the tackle made right at about the 24-yard line.
Yeah, a lot of runs on first down, and when you can get 8 yards, I mean, this is going to open up a home run play here at some point on a play-action pass for Dalton Snead downfield.
So you can see in the Indoor Football League, coaches on the field, practically in the huddle, and we get a stop in play for a moment. The ball is at the 24-yard line. We approach halftime, and at halftime, there will be a discussion with the new Hall of Famer, Todd Tryon. You've got a lot of experience with the commissioner of this league, Todd Tryon. Coach Ricks?
Yeah, played together, coached. He was on my staff, and then he was able to come in and buy the team and lead us through quite a few more wins. And I think he's done an outstanding job as commissioner where the league is now compared to where it used to be and continues to grow in a positive direction.
Jamal Miles in motion to the right of Dalton Snead, but Shannon Brooks is the guy with the ball, and he is untouched into the defensive backfield. Boy, he got to that third level in a hurry before finally contact on him, and he'll get inside the 10 or to the 10-yard line, right at the 10 to bring up a first down, a great run by Shannon Brooks.
Well, and this is what we talked about Mass needs to look at doing. Send the offense one way and run the other way. You let their aggressive play take them out of the play here, and they have no one accounting for. Guys got to get off their blocks, and you can see the DBs are worried about getting beat deep.
Motion on the left side. Fake it, keep it. This time it's Dalton Snead who takes it himself. The quarterback goes in to the end zone for a Rattlers touchdown.
This is a great call because you saw guys yelling at each other, yelling at that defensive end the previous play. So this time, Kevin Guy goes, we're going to fake right at that same defensive end. He's going to chase the running back here. And then Dalton Snead's wide open. See, number 92 goes with the back. No one there to take Dalton Snead.
Dawson Evans on. And his kick is through. 22-0. The Arizona Rattlers in the IFL Championship game, leading the Massachusetts Pirates. Stand by, everybody. We'll return to Henderson and the championship game right after this. Jimmy Robinson will go back deep for the Massachusetts Pirates. Dynamic playmaker that he is, and we'll see if he is able to do something to help reverse the fortunes in this first half for the Massachusetts Pirates. 3 minutes remaining till halftime. It's the Arizona Rattlers with a 22-0 lead. Robinson hit hard by Niger Jackson, who knocks him down. It was like hitting a brick wall there. And Niger Jackson, a receiver for the Arizona Rattlers, called by Kevin Guy, maybe the toughest guy on that team. And I got to tell you, Coach Riggs, a wide receiver is not supposed to make special teams plays like this.
Yeah, and a lot of times you'll see him and Miles, the first guys down the field. It just seems, though, right now, Arizona is playing harder than Mass, and they're playing a lot faster because of it, too.
Physicality always a feature when these two teams play each other, but here today, the Arizona Rattlers just, they've got that decided edge.
Yeah,
the physicality factor.
Well, and don't look for Kevin Guy to think, hey, let's take the foot off the gas here either.
Connor Taylor, pressure in the quarterback up the middle. This pass is going to be off the fingertips here on the near side of the field. Benefield had a little time to throw the football, but T.O. Redding couldn't hang on with the one-handed effort.
Well, and the coverage was good downfield. He had nowhere to go but the check down. And then Arizona rallied up to tackle right away.
See Amari Alexander stepping up to hit the receiver as the ball arrives. 22-0. The Arizona Rattlers in front at halftime. Stick around. Joe Pequena will join you in the booth, everybody, to talk with Todd Tryon, the commissioner of the IFL. Benefield puts his guys in motion. He'll look down the middle. Now, break the pocket to run, and he is chased down by Connor Taylor at about the 11-yard line. The marker came out just as Benefield was breaking the pocket.
Yeah, it's going to be a hold. You can see just the frustration by Mass at the end of the plays, but also up front, the blitz is really, really causing havoc. You can see Robinson is not wanting to block Taylor every play. Taylor's able to get in there every time in the backfield, and it's making Benefield uncomfortable.
The referee speaking with Kevin Guy there, and you know, Connor Taylor came with pressure up the middle. Let's get the call from our game official.
Holding, number 74, offense. The penalty has been declined. Result of the play is third down.
So Coach Guy elects to take, instead of a you know, two-yard penalty step off, he is going to decline and make it third down at five here.
I think he's going to change it here.
Arizona head coach is now elected to enforce the penalty, which will be enforced half the distance to the goal. Replay, second down.
So he takes the distance over the down, and Benefield and his guys will set it up again from half the distance from the 3.5-yard line. So it's 1 3/4 of a yard line.
The bigger thing, though, is you keep them pressed back into that end zone. You feel that wall back there, and you watch their motion. Their motion is the timing is really poor. You don't get a full run at this, and he's going to want to get rid of that ball. He's going to see that blitz coming at him here.
Empty backfield. Here comes Connor Taylor with the pressure. Throw over the middle into coverage. It's broken up. And once again, the Rattlers making a play. It was Isaac Zico, the intended receiver. Jermaine Dobbs, the defensive back, the corner for Arizona, has had a marvelous season, especially the back half of the season. He's been everywhere making plays. He got a pick six in the Western Conference Championship game, and he's right there with coverage.
Yeah, and that's the thing I noticed most, Floyd, in that Western Conference Championship game, was the play of their defensive backfield. I mean, Nate Davis, who's one of the best pure passers I've ever seen, he had nowhere to go with the ball. I mean, guys were locked down. They could not get open.
1 minute remaining in the first half.
So the 1 minute warning is upon us, everybody, and the Arizona Rattlers defensively pinning their ears back. Let's see if they can keep making plays. Massachusetts needs to get something done. We'll find out what the last 60 seconds and a half look like in a moment. Stand by, everybody. It's the IFL National Championship. Hard to understate or overstate how important this possession is for Alejandro Benefield and his Pirates. Deep passes thrown right to the center fielder. And Devontae Merriweather, who has been a longtime Arizona Rattler, he's been an IFL Player of the Year on defense before in this league for this team. And he's the one veteran in a list of longtime veterans who has not won a championship with the Rattlers, and he makes a big play.
Yeah, we faced him a lot, him and Winfrey both. I think they're tremendous players. In fact, that 2019 season when we beat him in Glendale, he was Defensive Player of the Year, and I thought for sure he was moving up. I thought he had a tremendous year. That you celebrate the interception if you're Arizona, but it was actually a bad thing for him because field position-wise, Mass was going to have to decide, do we go for it or kick it out of bounds to give Arizona the ball at midfield? But you just keep going off momentum here. You don't ever want to say, don't make a play.
It's hard to tell a defensive back.
Yeah, yeah.
not to take the stat tick, right?
Especially a guy that has to make tackles all the time.
That's right. 22-0, Rattlers in front. Fastball on the near side. Corey Reed Jr. catches and puts it across the dasher board with a first down, about a 12-yard gain, and it stops the clock with 50 seconds remaining in this first half.
Well, and they were finally given a chance to go deep, but Dalton makes a great read. Man-to-man coverage, playing soft, really easy pitch and catch right there. And this is where you're seeing Dalton at his best. When you have a team on its heels, you got a run game going, and you can mix in some play action and then try to go over the top.
Sneed with the empty backfield. And he delivers. A sure pass, the short pass, is caught on the far side of the field. Short of the first down, that's Glenn Gibbons Jr. on the receiving end, and he'll get about 8 out of it.
Yeah, just again, hey, let's get the ball out of his hands. Let's eat up the clock. I mean, this is where Kevin is very good. That last minute of a half is where he really excels. And you see that elbow coming in, frustration from Holmes there. I mean, that's where it's going to really get costly on some extracurricular penalties against Mass.
Coach, I felt like everybody in the know called this as a defensive battle, and it would be a low-scoring game. Certainly, we've seen that today, but could you have expected the Massachusetts Pirates? So hold on a second. Cut back by Glenn Gibbons Jr., and on his feet inside the 5-yard line. He'll go down at the 4. I thought he was going to house that one for the Rattlers. It took somebody with the shoestring tackle, but what a run and a great cutback by Glenn Gibbons.
Well, and the effort now is terrible by Mass. I mean, you watch this play. They should use a timeout just to go out and address this. If you guys are professional athletes, you need to come out here and play. You watch the effort to tackle right here by Ford. Look at him just stop right there. I mean, you got to keep going. And Kevin's just going to burn this clock out now and try to get a score right before half, knowing he gets it again.
Rattlers have not spent a timeout in the first half. Massachusetts has two remaining, and now the clock will tick down. And, of course, the Pirates will try not to leave anything for the Rattlers to work with, so they're not calling a timeout right now. Other than, Coach, it might have been a good opportunity, as you said, get out there and do a little rearranging on defense.
Well, and, you know, and Coach Miller's not a yelling type guy. That's not his demeanor. That's not his style. Sometimes you got to get out of your comfort zone, though.
Arizona.
He needs to bring him in.
They're first
to the
half.
There needs to be some face-to-face talks about you guys are in the championship. This may be the only time you ever get this.
Please reset the game.
Are you
going to
go down like this, or are you
going
to come out fighting?
Timeout has been taken by the Arizona Rattlers. In these final seconds of the first half, a conversation with Commissioner Todd Tryon here in the booth coming up at halftime. And the culmination of a great season in the IFL, nearly 130 games executed to near perfection this season. What a great year it was in the IFL. It's so well run, so well organized. You know, there are other leagues out there in this country that just struggle to keep things going, but under the leadership of Todd and his office, the home office for the IFL does a wonderful job. The ownership groups in this league, it's been a great year.
Yeah, and the game day productions is where I think really getting better and better, and, you know, bringing community involved. Green Bay does an outstanding job getting their community there at the games. I mean, they have some really creative ideas, and that was another one of the reasons why they had such a great season. You play in front of big crowds, guys want to be there. Guys want to play in front of that.
Yeah, couldn't agree more. The Arizona Rattlers will have the football here with 16 seconds remaining. Working on a first and goal from the four. Handoff right side. Shannon Brooks, he is going to drive his way down inside the 1 yard line. Good effort again by Shannon. And a great job up front. You saw Cole Carter up there helping to lead
Arizona
the way.
That
offensive line for the Rattlers has been strong, has been stout. They've got a first team all offensive lineman and a league first teamer in Lamar Mady, of course, and his great experience with the team.
Yeah, he's been playing for a long time and still getting it done. And Brooks getting tackled at the one there was actually a good thing. Coach Guy was, you know, I'm not going to be mad if you score, but getting tackled there, we just want to make sure Mass does not have a chance. Robinson to get a ball on a kickoff or anything to hurt us going in the half.
You know, this is the great thing about the IFL, though, Coach. I mean, with 12 seconds remaining here, 11 seconds now on the clock, I got to tell you, you know, if you're the Rattlers, you know, you could misstep right here.
Yeah.
Massachusetts could gain a lot of momentum and make this game a lot closer, even in 11 seconds remaining. So Arizona has to do their best, take care of business. Hand it off. Shannon Brooks, he found a seam. He's in the end zone. That is an Arizona Rattlers championship game touchdown. Shannon Brooks.
How do you run into the end zone from the 1 yard line in the A gap and not even get touched? That should never, ever happen. I mean, this is unacceptable, and this is just frustration and confusion by Mass.
That was your hat on a hat blocking scheme up front, wasn't it? And
yeah.
everybody tied up their guy, and Shannon Brooks with a very little struggle to get into the end zone. Apparently only ran a second off the clock as well. Here's the kick by Evans. Rattlers will have that one tacked on. He's been very accurate this season. A 29-0 lead going toward halftime.
Well, Floyd, going back to what you were saying, though, one of the greatest games I've ever witnessed was this season, Northern Arizona against Bay Area, down 20 points with a minute 20 left. They found a way to score get a drop kick, onside kick, get that. They ended up kicking a deuce the last play of the game to win the game. It was an unbelievable finish. I recognize Coach Moss. I think that staff, with the adversity they faced, did a tremendous job this season. I mean, what they had to go through and get their players to play through, really a challenge, and you got to tip your hat to them. But you're right, 20 points in a minute and 20 seconds, it can be done, and they showed that.
10 seconds remaining here in this first half of the championship game for the Massachusetts Pirates. Can they put points on the board? Get something to give them a lift going into halftime and a start for the second half. Unfortunately for them, the Arizona Rattlers are going to get first in the second half after everything they've done here.
I would expect the same thing. First down, run Shannon Brooks, heavy run, set things up, quick throws, and what we talked about, safe plays to keep it high percentage to not give Mass any chance with an easy turnover.
Dawson Evitz, and the liner is going to bounce up into the hands of Isaac Zico, crossing the field. He's getting some yardage. He's into field goal range, and he's driven out of bounds near the 10-yard line of Arizona. There's a marker down back at the 15 of Massachusetts. And unfortunately, the good return is going to be negated. Holding on the return team.
During the return, holding, number 21, receiving team. The penalty being forced half the distance to the goal from the spot of the foul. It is first down.
Well, and when things aren't going right, you find it just starts to roll downhill. Just keeps going that way, and instead of stopping it, you start to find excuses of why it's doing that, and that's when things just get worse. So Mass has got to go into half, address this, and say we got to start right away with one half of football. This is all we have left in our careers, possibly, and come out and give it everything we have.
So instead of being in striking range near the 10-yard line of the Rattlers after that good return,
timeout. Massachusetts.
Well, not
only second of the half.
Not only are they forced back to their own 8-yard line, and you've got that much field to cover, but they've got only 3 seconds to do it. So even if you thought, just get 3 points, get something out of this, they've kind of taken that off the board for themselves.
I mean, you saw it right there. There was confusion. Are we going to kick a field goal? What are we doing? They didn't even have enough players on the field, and you're still not sure what they're going to do here. But they got to be careful not to do something careless, turn the ball over here. I mean, really, I know it's humbling and you don't want to take a knee, but it might be the best thing right now for them, take a knee and get in the half.
Out of the timeout, we're going to find out exactly what that strategy looks like. Alejandro Benefield. It's not a very familiar spot for him, down 29 in his long and great career in this league. I'm not sure he's ever looked up and seen his team trailing by this measure.
No, and we had some great battles with them last year. We had to come back from some double-digit leads, but yeah, something like this he's not accustomed to.
Throws down the middle. He's got his guy. They're going to do the hook and ladder, modified version of it. And Jimmy Robinson ended up with the ball after Darren Carrington made the catch, and Robinson gets driven into the boards to take off the final seconds of the first half. And the body language says a lot right there as Alejandro Benefield makes his way off the field to halftime. Stand by, everybody. That's how the game started right there, and it didn't get much better for Massachusetts. 29-0 Arizona at halftime. We'll have Todd Tryon and more coming up as we break down on our halftime report straight ahead. This is the Indoor Football League's championship game. Stand by.
And we welcome you back to the Lees Family Forum. Halftime of the IFL National Championship, Joe Pequeno alongside Las Vegas head coach Mike Davis. And Mike, needs to say, one team has showed up in a big way, and the Arizona Rattlers have dominated this first half. Your thoughts on what you've seen?
I mean, they came to play. Obviously, you know, the Pirates are struggling offensively. You know, and they got to get the quarterback settled in. You know, you got to be able to complete some passes, and you got to find a run game.
We talk about physicality. At the media day, I asked both coaches how physical would this game be. Amari Alexander set the tone with the big hit on Jimmy Robinson that forced the fumble. We saw that on special teams with Nigel Jackson on the big hit on special teams. Your thoughts on the physicality Arizona's bringing to this game?
You know, that's what Kevin preaches in Arizona. You know, they're going to show up and they're going to be physical, and it's going to be a workmanlike mentality. You know, I call it more of a blue-collar type team. And, you know, Mass just hasn't seen anything like that yet on the East. And unfortunately, they're just they're getting kind of thrown around. Obviously, they're going to make a lot of adjustments in the second half, but they got to have a stop in the first drive. Otherwise, it's over with.
So, Mike, I don't know if there's an ER unit in the house, but right now, Massachusetts is literally on life support. If you're the coach, if you're Coach Miller, what do you say to your team to try to spark the fire and get back in this one?
You got to rally around your leaders, the guys that got your back. You know, there's guys out there that are playing hard, and there's guys out there that need to step up. And, you know, this is where you can find a hidden gem. You know, you got to have somebody that can make a play. And right now with Thomas Owens not playing because he's hurt, you know, you got to go to Isaac Zico and Jimmy Robinson, and those guys got to make plays for you. Otherwise, it's a good night.
So Massachusetts is looking for their playmakers to step up. As you look at this first half, and obviously the Rattlers got here by knocking off your team in the last second in the first round, how much better has this Arizona Rattlers team gotten in the course of the season?
You know, obviously we saw them early, and they had some injuries. We saw them late, which they were healthy, and we were fortunate enough, and we didn't make the plays in the when they came up here for the playoff game. But they've stayed to the course, and they've done what they're playing, and we said it after we lost. You know, whoever wins that game was going to win the championship, just because the physicality part of it. I thought we were way more physical than us and Arizona were the two most physical teams on the West, I thought. You know, it's kind of showing its ugly head today.
So if you're Kevin Guy and the Rattlers right now, you have this dominating halftime lead, up 29-0. Look, Kevin Guy is not the kind of guy who's going to take the foot off the pedal. What do you think his message is going to be to his locker room?
No turnovers and no stupid penalties. No big plays. Make them drive the ball. You know, big plays is what gets you back in the game. So I'm playing soft on defense. Obviously, Kevin's a man guy. So I'm playing a little softer. I'm making sure we secure all the tackles. I'm making them have 5, 6, 7 minute drives if possible. And the time's just going to run out on you, because they've shown they can't stop you offensively.
And Mike, for Las Vegas to be the host city of the IFL National Championship, how great of an experience is it to be the host city and to put on such a fine game, and everyone involved, from the volunteers to the staff to the Lee's Family Forum staff that do such a great job here?
You know, it's we try to make it just like if we were playing in it. You know, the hospitality is big for us. The game day production is big for us. And, you know, obviously we'd like to see a few more fans in the seats, but, you know, you're not getting Mass fans to show out here. And Arizona had a great crowd show up. My hat's off to everybody involved.
That is Mike Davis. We'll have more from Henderson, Nevada, right here from the IFL National Championship. This is halftime of the IFL National Championship, where it's all Arizona 29-0 over Massachusetts. Joe Pequeno alongside the commissioner of the IFL, Todd Tryon. And Todd, pinch me right now, because I'm absolutely stunned by this halftime result. Arizona is simply dominating on the scoreboard.
Yeah, and I don't know if it's Massachusetts playing that poor or Arizona being that well coached. You know, it just looks like that Arizona's a step ahead on about every single play, and, you know, that's kind of what's happening. I mean, Massachusetts is a talented squad, and, you know, they've got hot late, and, you know, I got to believe that they're making some adjustments there at halftime to make this a little more competitive in the second half.
Let's start with the Arizona defense. 5 stops in that first half, and Amari Alexander really set the tone with the bone-crushing hit on Jimmy Robinson to force that fumble. And ever since then, you see those Rattler bodies defensively. They're flying all around the field.
He did. They took a big shot early, and it looked like Massachusetts just has not recovered, you know, since taking that blow. And, you know, it Benefield looks like he's a little nervous. He's playing a little nervous out there. And, you know, they just have not been able to get any momentum.
Offensively, what can you say about this Arizona offense that's only gotten better throughout the course of the season. They've scored on every offensive possession.
You know, Arizona was a team that was hurt early. They had a lot of players down, and, you know, their roster, they usually don't turn over many players. And, I mean, their IR list was full, and it just seemed like you could see them, especially with Dalton Snead. I mean, out, got hurt that first half of the first game, was out about 4 to 6 weeks, and then it, you know, it takes a little bit to get his confidence back. But it looked like about the back half of the season, you could see Arizona getting healthy, getting confidence, getting momentum, and you know, I think you're kind of seeing, you know, them in full speed right now.
Yeah, Dalton Snead, a local product from Scottsdale, Arizona, went to Horizon High. He wants to win a championship. He knows all about the Rattlers' legacy. The defense in the last five games has given up an average of 32 points or less, so they are on point. So take us inside the Massachusetts locker room. If you're Rod Miller, what is the message to your team to try to get something going in the second half?
I mean, wake up. I mean, that's the first thing I'm saying is, hey, listen, we're not on East Coast time right now. We're on West Coast time, and, you know, we got to wake up. We took a blow early, and, you know, some of you didn't get off the mat. And we got to stand up, and we got to go out, and, you know, we got to play a little more competitive and, you know, make it look like you want to be here.
Todd, for you, a big night last night being inducted into the IFL Hall of Fame, I should say. What does that mean for you?
You know, appreciative. I mean, you know, you appreciate that you're recognized for, you know, the efforts that you put in for a lot of years. You know, it's a compliment to, you know, my supporting cast that I was able to surround myself with great people. You know, you can't accomplish what we accomplish without, you know, great friends and great staff and great fans and great sponsors. And, you know, just very, very appreciative.
That is Todd Schrein, the commissioner of the IFL. We'll have more from Henderson, Nevada right here on CBS Sports.
Game. I don't know if you remember, I said there's one or two throws Dalton makes each game that you're just like, what are you doing? See Jackson down at the bottom? Jackson's wide open, no one even near him. Pre-snap read, man-to-man coverage, go to your one receiver side instead of trying to force that in that tight window and giving Mass a chance to make an interception.
So third down and 10, and the Rattlers saw so much success in that first half. We'll see if they can get a chunk play for the first down. They throw across, and Shannon Brooks is going to get knocked out a couple of yards shy of the first down. He got into Pirates territory before Montgomery. Sam Montgomery able to snip out there and help out on defense.
And I would suspect Kevin he'll go for this here. But it puts him in a manageable fourth down situation now. But a big play for Mass here. They've had no momentum this entire game. This could be the first time to get something going their way.
Fourth down. And the Rattlers going for it all the way. Nothing surprising about that. Quarterback draw up the middle. Dalton Snead, first down and more. Across the 15 and the 10. And he is going to dive inside the 5-yard line. Snead to the 3-yard line, and he converts in a huge spot for the Rattler offense.
And Brooks just leads the charge here, and Dalton just finds a lane to get in there.
So Dalton Snead able to carry the ball to the 3-yard line. And it's first and goal for the Rattlers, trying to add to a 29-point advantage they have here in the championship game. Reed in motion on the right side, Shannon Brooks. And he tried to square up to the line of scrimmage, but there was that defense. And Massachusetts, and so many guys on both sides of the ball that are physical. On the defensive side, the guy that kind of plugged it all up is one of their keys, Israel Antwine. And you know, Jawad, the owner, talked about him specifically and his value to this team. He loves what he brings, loves what he means to his defense, and Israel with a great stop.
Yeah, stopping a run game, first, it's got to be up front. Your defensive line, because most teams are going to zone scheme. So D-line's got to be the ones that take that away.
So now from the 2-yard line, the Rattlers, Snead. Design quarterback sweep the entire way, and look who is there. It's Israel Antwine again with the big stop, making a huge play. And are we starting to see the emergence of that physicality of the Massachusetts defense that they're known for, and are they going to start to turn this game around right here?
Well, not only physicality, but some emotion. It's the first emotion we've seen all game. Great play. That was actually the play that Arizona ran against Vegas to get the game-winning touchdown right there. And Dalton walks in the end zone. Mass, nice job stopping that play. You can see right here, Arizona's giving their two guys some space to work with.
And throw the ball behind the receiver, Jamal Miles on the right side. And that is incomplete. And Massachusetts is able to force a fourth down now. It's going to be fourth and goal from the 8-yard line. This is a big moment for the Pirates. Let's see if they can turn the game around a little bit.
Yeah, and I'll say that was a bad series for Dalton Snead. I mean, all his throws, everything kind of seemed to be off. He seemed to be getting rid of the ball quickly, not knowing exactly where he's going with it. And you look for Kevin Guy to come back and get some quick throws and some run game going to settle him down.
Field goal try is on the way, and a 25-yard field goal is knocked through successfully by Dawson Evitz, and the Rattlers will add to their lead, but Massachusetts defense playing a little better football at the moment. 32-0, the Rattlers in front in this 2024 IFL Championship game. Stand by. He'll try the right side. And he takes it out to about the 14-yard line. That's where Massachusetts will have the ball on offense and see if they can get some second half momentum built here.
I'm surprised Arizona would kick to Robinson here, maybe trying to get one that goes on that back wall. But as far back as I can remember, there's never been a scoreless half where a team did not score a point. And that says a lot for Arizona's defense, the way they played that first half.
Certainly very unexpected, although I think most of us would have thought this would be a defensive struggle, just not somebody putting a goose egg up in a half. Here comes Benefield. Benefield across the 50-yard line, inside the 10, and Alejandro Benefield with a huge gain for Massachusetts, and they will for a rare opportunity, a rare moment in this game. They're going to be inside the 5-yard line after that big, big game by the quarterback.
Well, and they slant. Watch Arizona's line. They slant inside. The blitz comes outside, and Benefield's able to avoid the blitz. Everyone's in man defense, so they're chasing receivers. They don't even see him until way down the field. So huge play for Mass.
It took Dylan Winfrey peeling off his coverage to make the tackle at the 3-yard line. So first and goal, Massachusetts. Jimmy Robinson right side. Robinson to the end zone, and Massachusetts finally breaks the ice and gets their first points of the game.
And we talked about, you can't run at that D-line. They block down on the defensive end. They make sure Robinson's able to get outside, and there's no one there to tackle him. See, there's a block down on the D-end. Robinson's able to get the edge quickly and finish this one off.
Well, Joe was making a comment earlier about this Rattlers defense pretty much bottling up Jimmy Robinson. He hadn't done a lot today. Certainly has not been the key factor of the game. But at that time, it was the big guys up front that Massachusetts is so proud of that got that thing done. And here is the drop kick through the uprights. And there is a touchdown with the two-point add-on. Henry Nell from South Africa with the drop kick. The kick is good. And it's 32-8 as we get the second half underway. And the Pirates finally able to get something going on offense.
Well, and there's other ways to accumulate more points. So, you know, if they feel like the tough part kicking the deuce here is you got to go around the clock, though. We'll see. They tried it on their first one. Do you try it again just to try to get 2 points? Put them at the 5-yard line. Start to wake up your team. You see them playing with some emotion now, which they lacked that entire first half.
Yeah, you got to get points any way you can. So we'll see if Massachusetts elects.
It looks like he's going to, too, where he's lined up. Either that or an onside kick.
Yeah, trying to kick around the scoreboard, right?
Yep.
Henry Nell is the kicker. Just added the drop kick. Now we'll see if he is going to attempt. He is going to try to get the deuce, and this one is on the way. It's a good-looking kick, but it's going to be right. Sales right, had the distance. Kept it a bit of a low trajectory to try and avoid any possible interference from the scoreboard. There's a net that does protect each of the screens on the opposite sides of the scoreboard. Tried to go around everything, but the four iron was just a little bit to the right there.
Yeah, he tried to shoot that one low through the trees. Just couldn't get enough hook on it. It's going to be tough. That's going to be tough to do. And when you do that, the price you pay is you give Arizona the ball at midfield every time.
So the Rattlers get the great field position. They open up this possession on a give to Niger Jackson. First time he's been able to handle the ball today. And Niger is going to battle and fight his way. I mean, he was out of bounds. I think they're going to give him a generous spot here near the 10-yard line. Almost like a reward for all of the effort made, because he was battling along that dasher board, kept going well after the first contact that drove him into the sights.
Yeah, I think if we see on the replay, Arizona gets away with a hold here. And part of it's because the ball's coming at the referee. You'll watch, see 21 shooting in right there, Miles, yeah. He's hooking that guy. Those are the calls. Mass has got to get some of those to help things go their way.
So the ball is right at the 10-yard line, first and goal for the Rattlers. Hand off to Shannon Brooks. He'll go one-on-one with the defender, and it is going to be a nice open field tackle that's made right at the line of scrimmage.
Well, you see one adjustment they made. That's a play the first half. Mass had no answer to stop that. Now they have Ford assigned to Brooks. Wherever Brooks is going, Ford's going to be right there with him.
That was Paris Ford on the tackle. No gain on the play. Second down and goal. So Massachusetts, in little bits and pieces in this second half, are starting to match the Rattlers. And, in fact, I think they've kind of outplayed Arizona with the exception of that field goal.
I agree. And some of it's been their red zone defense right here. And if they get a stop here, you see things start to get a little tighter and a little more nervous for Arizona.
Motion from Twins, and here comes Dalton Snead. He's going to have to improvise a bit, and that pass is deflected. Good pressure coming from Jablonski Green, and he is able to knock the pass incomplete.
And really good coverage by Mass. Sometimes the best pass by a quarterback is just that throwaway pass. Don't put your team in a bad situation. Live to see another down. Good defense by Mass here.
Pirates are the champions from 2021. The defending champions, of course, this season, that was the Bay Area Panthers. And I mentioned before that the Rattlers won the championship in 2017. They, in their first year in the league, in the IFL, they defeated the Sioux Falls Storm. Nobody has won more than one championship in that time frame, and the Rattlers looking to become the first team to win two since 2017. But, of course, Massachusetts still alive in this game. Now just down 2.5 scores, they've got an opportunity for sure to, especially if they can get a stop in a situation like right now. Fourth down and goal coming up for the Rattlers.
Well, and defensively, that's what you want to do. You want to put yourself in fourth down situations. These are the downs you got to win. You got here, here's the chance to end this drive.
Good tackle across the middle by Cyrus Fagan. And Dalton Snead will put guys in motion to his right. Looking to throw, here it comes. Pass caught in the end zone. That is Jamal Miles with the Rattlers touchdown, his second of the game.
Yeah, and they do a nice rub route. They give Miles plenty of room to work with. Great route. You see he goes inside the receivers, and then he's just going to speed cut it out. A little push off. That's not going to get called. That's a seasoned vet right there going to their go-to guy.
Jamal Miles, one of the members of that 2017 Arizona Rattlers championship team. It has been a long, long time for that veteran in getting back to a championship game, and now perhaps a championship looming for him and his teammates. Big lead for the Rattlers. Stand by. We'll be back with more of the championship game right after this. A-League action as Hellas Verona takes on Napoli at 12:30 Eastern on CBS Sports Network and streaming live on Paramount+. And this Arizona Rattlers kick is going to go into the end zone, and perhaps somebody out here scouting might need to talk to that young lady with the big catch. Great catch outside the Dasher board. That's what you come to these games for. One of the things, try to get a souvenir, and you're up, you're so up close and personal to the action, and that'll be a touchback out to the 20-yard line. Well, the IFL's championship game underway in Henderson, everybody. Floyd Simmons, along with my broadcast partner, the great Curtis Riggs, coach. Before I stepped all over you right there.
Arizona just keeps flirting with that back wall, not trying to give Robinson a chance to get a kickoff there. I'm sure Coach Guy's content with, that's okay if it went out of bounds here. Let's get our defense lined up.
And they'll line up facing the Massachusetts offense at the Pirates' 20-yard line. Alejandro Benefield fake it to Robinson, throw off the back foot. There is some contact downfield. Amari Alexander was the defender, and he was trying to stay step for step with Dante Dimas Jr., the receiver. And there's a marker down.
Yeah, and I think Dimas is who's filling in for Owens. But this is what Arizona's going
to
do.
They're
going to grab on.
Holding, number 24, defense. 10-yard penalty, automatic first down.
They're going to grab on to avoid giving up that big play. And they're going to say, we'll give that penalty up instead of getting beat for a touchdown.
31-point Rattlers advantage. And after they mark off the penalty from the line of scrimmage, Massachusetts now parked at the Rattlers' 20-yard line. Benefield puts them in motion. Fake it again to Robinson. Throw back in his direction. And there is Devontae Merriweather reading that one all the way, and he got both hands on the ball, but it's incomplete.
Yeah, and an awkward play. Came down hard against that wall there. But you can see they're trying to throw to Robinson because they don't pick up the blitz. Oh, thank goodness he's okay.
Devontae Merriweather meet the Dasher board on that far side of the field.
There's zero give in that wall. That's just a hockey wall right there with the thin pad in front of it.
He's none the worse for wear. He is lined up at his spot at what the Rattlers defensively call the bandit position. Strong safety. We go under 3 minutes remaining in the third quarter. Benefield looks to his right now down toward the back of the end zone, and he just threw that one away. Incomplete, double coverage on the last receiver that he was looking at there. I think he was looking in the direction of Dimas.
Yeah, and great coverage. You can see what Arizona's doing is they're playing their guys deeper off of the receivers, and then it's easier for them to just jump that first move as the receivers start to make their breaks.
Rattler fan base well represented here today in Henderson. It's not a long drive from the West Valley, from Phoenix and the Glendale area where they call home to here in the Vegas area. But I'll tell you, it's hot the entire direction as this one is incomplete and out of bounds. A little high, a little behind T.O. Redding, the intended receiver.
Well, I remember we talked about first quarter, second half, that blitz. How's he going to start to affect the throws? Watch Benefield throws this sidearm. He knows he's got to get rid of that ball. He's got a blitz coming at him. Robinson's going to cut. He's got to go up to the line of scrimmage and cut. He can't stay back deep because Thornton will just jump over Robinson right into Benefield.
Big play on fourth down, fourth and 10, and the Arizona Rattlers defense is there, swallowing up the quarterback. Connor Taylor was the first guy there. Kevin Sims, he converged as well, and the Rattlers make yet another big defensive play today.
Benefield, nowhere to go with the ball. The blitz again, Robinson having to get pushed back into the quarterback. Mass needs to slip him by Thornton and let Robinson get downfield and just dump it down to him. You can see how that blitz has worn down Robinson and Benningfield both.
A good start to the third quarter by the Pirates and whatever goodwill they were building for themselves here in the championship game just got swallowed up by that quarterback sack. And now the Rattlers will take over the football. They get the ball back on a turnover on downs. And they'll work from their own 24-yard line. Here comes Dalton Snead. And he's got time to throw, and he'll get knocked down. And Snead did what I thought was a smart thing on that, coach, and that is just simply to swallow up the football and not risk anything.
Yeah, you'll see here in the pocket, he looks, and then he actually just protect the football, go down. They, again, live to see another play. I mean, that's what Dalton's got to do. You talked about it at halftime. He's got to manage this game for Arizona to come out with a victory.
That's Guy Thomas with the quarterback sack and a veteran play from a young quarterback who otherwise might have tried to make a play on that, and he understands well his team is in front by 31. Try not to make a catastrophic mistake, a one-handed pluck out of the air by Shannon Brooks trying to run that screen on the far side of the field, and Shannon will take this to the 23-yard line.
Yeah, they run this, and Mass actually does a pretty good job attacking to get there. Brooks just does a better
job
getting away.
That's the third quarter.
Well, that play that brings it back to near the original line of scrimmage will bring a third down at 10. The third quarter expires, and these two teams are 15 minutes away from someone being crowned the new IFL champion for 2024. Stand by for the fourth quarter coming right up after this. Of the 2024 Indoor Football League National Championship game in Henderson, Nevada. Floyd Simmons along with Coach Curtis Riggs. And the Arizona Rattlers have possession of the football to start this fourth quarter. And they're looking straight into the teeth of a third down and 10 set versus this Massachusetts defense. Step up and throw through the hands of Jamal Miles. Well, catchable ball downfield would have been a first down, but Jamal couldn't hold on to the Dalton Snead pass attempt, and that brings us to a fourth and 10 for the Rattler offense.
Yeah, and surprise, it looks like he's going to go for this here. He must feel like he has a play. I mean, Miles is wide open there, just the little bit high there. Usually a ball he's going to bring in, though.
Plenty of time for Dalton Snead to set and deliver into the middle of that Massachusetts zone. Pirates were for a long time known for playing almost strictly zone. They'll do a lot more man in the new iteration of this defense. And coming up the middle with pressure, knocking the pass down, C.J. Colden.
Yeah, as much field position there, anything else. You miss field goal, it goes to the 5-yard line here. Gets knocked down, Mass gets the ball midfield. That's a nice job by the linebacker, though, being big, visible in Dalton's face, not giving him a window to throw. That's another weakness I've seen with Dalton's career. He does get a lot of balls knocked down. That one, though, I think anyone would have got knocked down there.
Yeah, great job, and let's provide a correction. That's Jaden Woodby. Woodby is the defender that brought the pressure, made the great play for Pirates defense, and forces the turnover on downs. Too little, too late, we'll find out. 39 to 8, a 31-point lead for the Rattlers here in the championship game. And Alejandro Benefield. Jimmy Robinson flanking him in the backfield, and Benefield to throw all the way. He's got a man. That's Zico with the catch, and he's got a first down, and he stays on his feet, stays alive. I hear no whistles. I don't see an indication. The official nearest the dasher board that might have called him out of bounds is not going to, and he is the guy that indicates a touchdown.
Yeah.
Touchdown, Massachusetts.
And this is going to be a challenge. I mean, I think he clearly hit the wall. I mean, we'll see on a replay. Yeah, he did. He had a hand still on the wall.
Well, let's have a look at the replay ourselves.
He hits the wall, bounces off, but his hand's still touching it when the defender's touching him. Hits it, And then he reaches over there. Yeah, he should be down.
There's contact. We'll see if Coach Guy wants to throw the. He's got the challenge flag in hand, and he will throw it just before the snap. What would have been a
drop kick. The cat and mouse there, wait until last second.
Sure.
Yeah, look at him.
You know, the other thing that happens right there, by the way.
Arizona head coach is challenging the previous play, stating there was contact into the wall. Previous play will be under further review.
I think he's going to win that challenge. But the other thing, by waiting, not just cat and mouse, not just a little mental game, but the clock is running the whole time.
A little more time. Yeah, exactly. Yeah. I mean, you know, the clock's the biggest enemy right now for Mass, but it's also the biggest thing that Arizona gets scared of too.
So they are taking a look at the replay. The officials on the field looking at the big screen, you can see that. And the game official is going to have a different screen to look at. Take a little more up close. The referee will take a little more up close look at it.
Yeah, he gets pushed. But great play by Zico. You saw that play, though. Mass tried to slip Robinson by Thornton. He was able to get by, but Benefield just went to Zico right away.
So they continue to look at this one. We'll have a judgment in a moment. Hey, by the way, I want a little shout-out to the director of officiating in the IFL. That's Tom Felsinelli. I know you know him well. He's been doing this, I think, for 12 years as the guy directing it. And I met him yesterday for the first time at the media day for the IFL, and among the things we talked about is the commitment this league has to continually upgrade and improve the officiating in the league. And I just thought what I heard from him was a confirmation of all the work that they do. They just continue to do what they can to put the best officials on the field, and they never stop in that pursuit. They're always working toward that end.
Yeah, and a great job. Tom does an outstanding job. Works his tail off. One of those
upon
positions.
Further review, the runner was contacted into the wall at the 7-yard line. It will be first and goal from the 7-yard line. Arizona has won the challenge, retained their challenge, as well as their timeout. First down.
It's one of those spots where there's really not a lot of gratitude. You know, usually it's only when things stand out, but they do a tremendous job. Tom puts in countless hours. And the thing you love is Todd Tryon's also open and willing to try to, hey, let's keep improving every year with that.
13 minutes, 8 seconds remaining in this IFL championship game. Jimmy Robinson. And Robinson will try to squirt through that defensive line, and he does get yardage down to about the 2, or just inside the 2-yard line for Massachusetts.
Kind of something they've gotten away from since early in that first drive of the game of running Robinson. I can't believe they huddle, though. Yeah, I mean, that's just blowing me away. I mean, you got to score points as fast as possible. Using the play clock here, it's already down to 10 seconds. I mean, you got to get going.
Benefield. He'll try to run it himself. Not going to happen. Well, I don't know who's going to get credit for the tackle, but Kevin Sims needs to get credit for blowing the play up.
Yeah, he did. He's the one that made Benefield cut back inside. Not a strength. You know, Benefield running with power there. You see he's kind of hobbled, kind of limping a little bit.
Now, Alejandro has... He has taken a lot of abuse today at the hands of that Rattlers defense.
Timeout.
Timeout taken on the field.
Massachusetts, their first of the second half.
They're going to discuss it and maybe give their quarterback a little respite as well. We grab a timeout here on the broadcast. 39-8. That's the lead for the Arizona Rattlers in the 2024 Indoor Football League National Championship game. Down to week 0 is on Monday night at 8 o'clock Eastern. Join CBS Sports Network's Inside College Football team as they get you ready for a brand new season. And look at this. The Arizona Rattlers
do it again. Devontae Merriweather with an interception to stymie and stop another Massachusetts effort to get into the end zone.
What? I mean, there's question of who was going to be the MVP. That might have just secured that right there. Merriweather, his second interception, and this one, a dazzling one here. Benefield never even accounts for him because he attacks against the run, then quickly gets back.
Interception for a touchback. After the play, sportsmanlike conduct number 55, Massachusetts. That 15-yard penalty being added to the end of the play. Automatic first down. This is number 55's first and sportsmanlike conduct foul of the game.
Well, frustration like you might expect with 11 and a half minutes remaining in regulation, and your team with another mistake like that one. If there was a dagger delivered, that's probably the moment right there. I don't know how, if you're Massachusetts, you come back from that.
Yeah, and now the clock's just going to continue to run. I mean, you want short plays, long drives here, unless you're just going to capitalize with a big touchdown.
So Dalton Snead lines them up, and he hands it off to Shannon Brooks around the near side. And Shannon smartly cuts it back to the field of play to keep the clock moving. Well, it's going to move anyway.
Yep.
But he's able to help his team secure yet another chunk of time off the clock and a big 8-yard gain, which opens up the playbook a little bit.
Yeah, and you just want to avoid penalties. Penalties and then, of course, turnovers. But Arizona just wants to come. They want to just play smash-mouth football and just go right down Mass's throat here.
And they are parked at the 21-yard line of the Pirates. Miles in motion. Brooks the ball. And Shannon Brooks gets knocked down after first down yardage. Gains about 4 on the play, and that will move the chains. And the Rattlers move a step closer to a championship trophy.
Yeah, and Finale, I mean, he is moving people there. Anytime you get a body that big and you're going that fast out there and people get in your way, they're going to pay the price for it.
Listen, the Rattlers have put together a great collection of guys, both on the offense and defensive lines, but it has been surprising how much more effective those units have been for the Rattlers than Massachusetts today, because Pirates are no slouches up front. Here's a fake and a take by the quarterback, and it's going to go to about the 12-yard line for Dalton Snead.
Yeah, you're right. We talked to the owner before the game, and the first thing he said was their D-line, how good they were. And I think Arizona's came out and really established the line of scrimmage. Now, I will say Arizona, they should dominate in the recruiting area. I mean, you're recruiting New Phoenix. You're recruiting to play in Glendale in front of the largest crowd in the league. You have a great owner, an experienced coach. It's really tough to recruit against that sometimes for other teams. And Kevin's taken full advantage of that here.
Brooks again, right side, and Shannon Brooks is going to be into the end zone. It looked like he might have contacted the boards inside the 5, but they say, nope, that was clean. And Shannon Brooks has a touchdown.
Yeah, again, great play call. Away from his trip set. Shannon Brooks, though, done a great job finishing his runs, getting in the end zone here.
Shannon Brooks is in that conversation for most valuable player of the game.
Yeah, he's had kind of that quiet, great game here.
And Dawson Evans is perfect today with points after for the Rattlers, as really he has been throughout the season. And an Arizona domination continues. 46-8, they lead here in the fourth quarter. This is the Indoor Football League's national championship game. Stand by. 8 minutes and 40 seconds remain in regulation of this national championship game in the Indoor Football League. Welcome back in, everybody. 46-8, the Arizona Rattlers. They have gone into domination mode. Here's the kick fielded by Jimmy Robinson, about 6.5 yards deep. And he'll bring it out to about the 7-yard line, and that's it. This coverage team for the Rattlers has been so, so good down the stretch of the season. Special teams has really lifted this Rattlers team in many ways and helped them to a number of victories down the stretch. And one of the guys responsible for that is
also a guy who deals with the big boys up front. I'm talking about Jeff Jarnigan, the general manager and one of the coaches of the Arizona Rattlers team. I don't know if we'll be able to get a shot of him on screen, on camera, but with Jeff Jarnigan, and he went through so much this season, a monumental health scare where he almost lost his life and was able to come back from that. His health has improved dramatically, and his presence on the field, his involvement as a coach and a stabilizing force there in the locker room, Jeff Jarnigan being with this team and being healthy has been so important for his team, for Kevin Guy, for the entire team. But Jeff Jarnigan, coach, he deserves a little bit of mention as well here and all the success the Rattlers are having today, but always have.
Well, he's a huge part of their success. I mean, you bring a guy in that's got years of valuable coaching, head coaching experience back in the Arena League, San Jose, and he's been with Kevin a long time. They read each other very well. He's the one that's key for their success on, you're right, on the special teams. I mean, tonight, their kickoff team has been fantastic. The play of their D-line, he's after that. But, yeah, more importantly, his health is doing better from early in the season. He's an awesome, awesome human being, and he's one that keeps Kevin very level-headed at times when Kevin can easily lose his cool. Jeff can pull him back in.
And a pass play to Darren Carrington brings it out to the 19-yard line. First down for the Pirates. Alejandro Benefield to work. And he will throw and deliver, and that's into the stands. Incomplete. He was looking for T.O. Redding downfield. And frustration continues to mount for the Pirates as the clock continues to roll its way down. Under 7 minutes remaining in regulation. We'll find out what the flag is all about.
Personal foul, illegal block below the waist, number 3, offense. 10-yard penalty from the previous spot, remains first down.
See, you can cut block, but you can't go outside the box and come into the box and cut block. I mean, that's pretty dangerous. He's coming out, coming in. The linebacker, Thornton doesn't, or Taylor doesn't see him. I mean, that's a pretty dangerous act where Taylor can't protect himself there. That's a good call by the officials right there.
And the Pirates will work in a long situation here. Second down and looks like a little better than 20 to go. Deep into double coverage. And Devontae Merriweather has another interception for the Rattlers and some return yardage as well. He'll go inside Pirates territory. Well, there's the third interception today for a guy who deserves his moment. Devontae Merriweather has given so much to this Arizona Rattlers defense, this franchise, and his many years in uniform with them. And he is having the game of his life in the biggest, on the biggest stage.
Yeah, he's just playing center field. He's just back there playing center field, goes over and catches the pop fly of Benefield's throw and takes advantage of, makes his third interception. You know, I think Brooks gets a score, and Merriweather thinks, I better make another play to try to wrap this MVP trophy up here.
Well, if you get three interceptions in a game, in a championship game, boy, you know, the guys on the offensive side have to do something pretty extraordinary to take that MVP away from you.
I'm sure if we had staff records of the championship games, that's probably something that's never been done, too.
And we got a new quarterback into the game. And on his first carry of the game, he is going to take it for the touchdown. The first carry of the game for Garrett Kettle results in a touchdown for the Arizona Rattlers.
Yeah, the best part here, I mean, Kettle, he can run. There's no doubt about this. That's his strength. But the first guy to come out and celebrate with him, Dalton Snead. He gets out there on the field right away celebrating with Kettle.
Yeah.
And the backbreaking touchdown is scored. The point after is on the way and good. And we'll grab a timeout. Arizona 53, Massachusetts 8, with exactly 5 minutes remaining in regulation. Stand by, it's the IFL's championship game. Back to Henderson right after this. Rattler fans with a lot to cheer about on this afternoon in Henderson, Nevada, the Vegas area, the home of the IFL's championship game this and the past two seasons. And we're going to find out, I'm sure, in the weeks that follow where the next championship will be held. I know that the IFL would like to return here to Henderson. The Lees Family Forum would like to have the IFL back. And those discussions will be had. Here comes the return by Jimmy Robinson. He is in the open field and pushed out by Dawson Evans, the kicker. And he's going to go out somewhere around the 12-yard line of Arizona territory. And we are under 5 minutes now remaining in this championship game. Wood Simmons and my broadcast partner is the coach, Curtis Riggs. Well, coach, you find yourself in this position now if you're on the top end of that score. There's virtually nothing that Massachusetts could do in this final four and a half minutes to overcome what you have been able to build. What do you do? What's how do you keep your guys going to the final bell here if you're the Arizona Rattlers?
Well, the Rattlers, you saw it right there. Guys aren't coming down quite as hard on kickoff. Surprised Kevin just didn't kick it out of bounds so they don't have to do that. And Mass is going to try to play this out. The Arizona guys got to play hard. When you don't play hard, that's when guys get hurt. Finish the game out here.
Benefield to the end zone. There is a lot of coverage back there. The catch is made. T.O. Redding goes up and brings it down, and that's a Massachusetts touchdown. They need the points. They need something, and they got something right there on that throw to the back of the end zone. There was contact between the receiver and the defender, but it was ultimately a touchdown for the Pirates.
Yeah, you're right. It looked like there was a lot of bodies moving here. and you can't see. It looked like, I think it was just the inadvertent contact that made him fall down there.
And the drop kick is on the way, and that one is good for 2 points.
Makes it look so easy, too, and it's so tough. I mean, he makes it just like, hey, this is a walk in the park here.
Yeah, the Pirates add two more right there. 53-16, Arizona leads Massachusetts in this championship game in Henderson, Nevada. Well, you know, Thomas Owens was lost to the Pirates. He hadn't been able to play today. They scratched him last night, I believe it was, kind of a last-second, late-second thing. They had to make that move. Thomas Owens, the receiver, unavailable for the Pirates. They could certainly use him on a day like this. But even with that said, he is not going to make 37 points of difference in a game against a team that is playing as well as I think you could ask an IFL team to play. The Rattlers have played so well lately. They had two great playoff victories, and all they've done is just take that level of play that got them those two wins and elevate it from there in this championship.
Yeah, I think what it looked like for me is one team that was really churning in all areas and ready to play, ready for this game, ready to play at that intensity level, and then another team that schematically game planning wasn't quite up to point and also didn't bring that intensity that they needed to play with a team like Arizona in this championship game.
See the veteran Jamal Miles on your screen. He is the lone receiver deep for the Rattlers as they bring everybody up in front. And do not get the potentially anticipated onside try by the Pirates. Down by this much, you wouldn't really expect that at that point. And the kick goes into the protective net in front of the
free
scoreboard.
Free kick hit the overhead structure. Ball be placed at the 25-yard line. First down.
So that's where the Rattlers are going to get their offense back on the field. Garrett Kettle has taken over at quarterback for Arizona after a great game turned in by
the starter by Dalton Snead in his first year with the Rattlers. He overcame those early season injuries to get into some great championship form at the end of the year.
You know, one of the things that's amazing, that Western Conference, there was a point in the season, even late, where it was a question if Arizona was even going to make it. And they had to go out to San Antonio against the offensive rookie or player of the year and win that game to make sure they got into the playoffs.
Shannon Brooks trying to work some time off the clock, running straight into the teeth of the Pirates defense. And he is able to get to about the 24-yard line. 1 yard gain, and the clock continues. It's marched down toward 3 minutes.
I would talk to Coach Guy during the season, and he was steadfast saying that, hey, I think we have a good group. I think we, if we can just get going on track, these are the guys that we want right here. Well, he figured it out, and he got them clicking at the right time.
Brooks again reverses field. And there isn't a whole lot room for him to run. He gets brought down, and I believe it was straight up the middle of the linebacker that is able to take care of him.
Yeah, Brooks looks gassed. He's asking, hey, can I maybe get a break here?
And it was Dante Dimas with the defensive play. For the Pirates, 2 minutes and 14 seconds remaining. The final minute, you get the normal stoppages of play if the ball goes into the sidelines or any complete pass or anything else. The final minute will, the clock rules change. Here's an incomplete pass off the hands of Corey Reed Jr. So Garrett Kettle, opportunity to throw the football, and it's incomplete. The Rattlers are going to win a championship. It will be their seventh championship ever in indoor football in the different leagues that they played in. The AFL, preceding their time in the IFL here now since 2017, will be their second IFL championship.
Yeah, that's quite an achievement. I mean, that's great. I think more than anything for Kevin to come back after, you know, he'd won it in 2017, then lost us in 2019, and then just couldn't quite get over the hump to get back in here. Some great games, but now come in and play this well, too.
How about that defensive play? I believe that was one of your defensive linemen peeling off the play to make it. Jablonski Green lays out for it. Is a defensive lineman supposed to be able to make a play like that?
Well, and he actually does not want to challenge this. He does not want to challenge this because if he challenges it, it'll go, they'll actually gain yards from it because it was fourth down. You know, Kevin's like, hey, did that hit the ground?
It was Guy Thomas, actually. Guy Thomas, the guy that makes that play for the Pirates.
Yeah, and I think Kevin just figured that out. He's like, hey, I challenged this. I don't think he caught it, but it actually gained us some yards.
So it did. And the ball goes to the 8-yard line. And the Rattlers are going to bring the defense back out to try and close out this final minute, 7. A lot can happen in these last seconds of the game, but the Rattlers are surely going to be on the podium here in a bit. And we'll work our way down to the 1 minute warning.
There is 1 minute remaining to regulation.
Stand by, everybody. The Arizona Rattlers just that 60 seconds away from a championship. We'll continue with the 2024 IFL National Championship game right after this. Back in for the final 60 seconds of this 2024 National Championship game, the IFL's championship. A champion to be crowned in a moment. Benefield will peel out of there and go out of bounds with a short gain. Short gain on the play. More of that Rattlers defense on display. They had the pressure on the quarterback. They had the coverage downfield. Little could be done by Alejandro Benefield.
And that's consistent. I mean, he's had very small windows to throw or usually someone in his face when he is going to throw. And that's been just about all game long.
check the second down play. That clock stopped with 54 seconds remaining. And a tackle made on the field of play. We'll see if Massachusetts spends one of their final two timeouts. Well, Coach Riggs, this Arizona Rattlers team overcame a lot of adversity this season to get here. There were a ton of injuries at the beginning of the year. I mean, I don't know. They had eight of their guys injured at one point in the first few weeks. They went a whole month without a victory. They started the season 1-3 before they finally got some guys back, started getting on a roll. Took a while to get used to the new quarterback, Dalton Snead. Took a while for Coach Guy, Kevin Guy, to get used to Dalton as a quarterback and figure out what his strengths and weaknesses were. You see this ball go incomplete downfield. A lot of adversity. But one of those things that this team, they moved the team, by the way, in the middle of all of that. They're moving from the East Valley to the West Valley in the Phoenix area. It was a lot of difficulty to overcome. But one of the things that had a lot of fans questioning and ought to give Kevin Guy a lot of satisfaction was this team parting with a former MVP caliber quarterback that they had before. The Drew Powell, great quarterback, and, you know, multiple MVPs in the league. But to move on from him and to bring in a new quarterback, Dalton Snead, as they did, and the way they kind of struggled dealing with injuries and stumbling around for a little while at the beginning of the season, well, you had a lot of fans questioning the wisdom. But, you know, Kevin Guy never backed off of his decisions. Never backed off his decision to walk away.
Offense. 5-yard penalty remains fourth down.
To walk away from Drew Powell and his level of satisfaction with all of that happened, all those decisions, has to be just preeminent right now. He's got to really feel good, and he deserves a pat on the back for not just the tough decisions made, but for staying with it when there was so much pressure on him during those early days of the season.
Yeah, and 22, when we had Dalton, I wanted him back in the worst way. He just couldn't come back to Sioux Falls to that. He had to stay closer to home. I called Coach Guy and said, hey, you need to sign this guy. I know Drew, he's a tremendous player, great player, played for us for a while. He's done great things for you, but this is your guy right here. And I did that for Dalton because I just think so much of him. Kevin Guy stuck with his guy, Drew Powell, and then he had to watch Dalton Snead go to Bay Area and beat us in the championship game. And then finally was like, all right, let's give this a shot. And it's paid off. And you're right. It's paid off, and Kevin Guy's able to answer that call, and deservingly so. I think the other thing is you list all those issues during the season. You also have to give credit to the Western Conference. The Western Conference was really good. And, I mean, it's a slugfest every time they would play teams. And you're going to lose some of those games, but then they figured out how to win them all towards the end of the season.
Anybody at the top of that conference, including a couple of teams that didn't even make the playoffs, you would have to put Northern Arizona into that mix. Anybody could have really come out of the West and probably won this championship. The East has some quality football, but I haven't seen conference play like we did in the West in my time in this league, which now goes back several years. It was a great competitive year like you're talking about, Coach, in the Western Conference. And here comes the final knee. It is Dalton Snead, tasked to go out, go under center, take the snap and a knee, and the Arizona Rattlers are your 2024 IFL National Champions. Dalton Snead, a guy that will be considered for MVP honors in the game today. He played such a great game, got into the end zone with the football. Shannon Brooks on offense played very well. Jamal Miles, I thought, had a great game. Multiple touchdowns in the game for the veteran receiver for the Rattlers. On defense, Devontae Merriweather, three interceptions, Coach.
I mean, I think you're being nice and trying to find positives. But Merriweather was the MVP today. I mean, to make those capitalizing plays, plus what he just did defensively. I think really, though, schematically, what they did was really the key ingredient, and the level that they came in as a team, how they played, is why it's somewhat tough to think about who is the MVP if we didn't have those three interceptions.
The Arizona Rattlers in dominating fashion, 53-16, the victory in the championship game today over the Massachusetts Pirates. And the celebration will commence here. And look at that guy right there, Dalton Sneed. Two championships now in his first two full seasons. And let's go down on the field, Joe Pequeno.
You know, talk about dominating our matchup, dominating our opponent, playing 6 minutes, we don't care what the score is. You know, we started off adversity this year. We got stronger as the season went on. Give our players all the credit, my coaching staff, ownership, our staff, football staff, our fans, Rattler Nation, great, they showed up big time today. Just great organization from top to bottom.
Coach, you talk about bringing the physicality. Amari Alexander did that in that first defensive possession. We saw Nigel Jackson on special teams. It seemed like the Arizona Rattlers were the more tougher physical team.
Arizona Rattlers, you got to go and your feelings in the back pocket. It's a team game. It's all about a team. We preach physicality from the day you walk in the door and domination. Just what a season. Remember this one for a long time, just for what all the stuff that we went through, you know. Had 9 injuries at the beginning of the season. We couldn't make any moves. Roster. All of my guys today, players deserve all the credit.
Thank you, Coach. Just throw it back upstairs.
Thank you, Joe. Kevin Guy, the head coach, the winningest head coach now these days in the indoor game. And that covers all iterations of indoor football. Nobody's won more games than Kevin Guy. And something tells me that none are more sweeter than the victory today for him and the Arizona Rattlers with a final of 53-16. Arizona is your IFL national champions. Pretty special time. Rattlers and their franchise. You talk about ownership. Well, Ron Schurz is one of those guys. He's the standard bearer, isn't he, for ownership in the IFL?
I think so. I think he does a great job of letting Kevin run the team, coach football, and hey, if you need me to back you up on something, I'm there. And I think that's always a good sign, you know, and then when he wants to contribute on some business, he's always first to say, I got a lot of coach, and I love the coach, and that's what he does. I think Kevin did a nice job trying to put it on the players and everyone, but the thing he needs to pat himself on the back for is, he had his guys ready to play, and they look like a championship-level football team here today.
How hard is it in this league to repeat as champions? I mean, here come the Arizona Rattlers, the first team to have 2 IFL championships since your Sioux Falls Storm last did it in 2016. How hard is it?
Yeah, it's tough. Yeah, I mean, it's difficult. It's just such a gauntlet. And Kevin talked about the injuries and the personnel and having to recruit your guys every year. It really makes it tough. Everyone else has gotten better, too. Getting your guys back is tough. So Kevin will have his work cut out for him, but you know he'll be up for the challenge.
All right, we got a quick break, everybody, and then the trophy presentation on the field here in Henderson. Stand by as we continue with our post game of the 2024 IFL National Championship. Massachusetts Pirates finished their season strong. 2 great playoff victories for them, both on the road. And a lot of road playoff wins, by the way, in the IFL this year. They had the number 3 and 4 seeds in the Western Conference that both won their opening round games and then met up in Phoenix. That was Phoenix and San Diego. On the other side, Massachusetts with 2 great wins over Frisco and Green Bay. You got to give them a lot of credit. They played great football down the stretch, but they just didn't have it on an afternoon here in Henderson that saw the Arizona Rattlers playing almost a perfect football game. I don't know how else you describe it. The Rattlers are the national champions of the IFL in 2024 after a 53-16 win over the Pirates.
They made an unbelievable late run to get themselves here. Had a heck of a back end of the season to be the Eastern Conference rep for the 2024 IFL season. So, Massachusetts Pirates, congratulations to all you guys and your organization. I also want to thank all of the owners from the IFL. They're here in attendance. here for a long weekend. Lee's Family Forum for an outstanding, being an outstanding host for our national championship game. So now if I can get some of the Arizona guys up here, we got two of the key guys. We'll do the trophy presentation. Well, it's been a long time coming for the Story franchise. Throughout the season, early on, they had some struggles, they had some injuries, but about week 10, week 12, you can see this team start to get healthy. It starts to get hot. And towards the back end of the season, they had a battle just to get into this. You know, but they did. And as playoffs started going, they just kept getting hotter.
Well, the Arizona Rattlers are your national champions, everybody, and Todd Tryon awarding that trophy now. Floyd Simmons, along with Curtis Riggs, been a great afternoon, Coach. Always great to work with you, and congratulations to the Rattlers.
Yeah, it's been awesome. Thanks. It's a privilege working with you, and congratulate Ron Schertz and Kevin Guy and the Arizona Rattlers. Well deserved. Definitely the best team.
Good afternoon, everybody. Have a great day. We'll see you next time. The IFL Championship game in the books. Bye-bye now.
get into this. You know what they did. And as the playoffs started going, they just kept getting hotter.
Great partnerships. We appreciate you here today, but I'll tell you what, changing the boys came out.